Snowflake's office is somewhere in the upper levels of the saloon. To find out what he's planning, our best bet is to plant a bug. Needless to say, we must remain undetected. Conveniently, I discovered they're looking for a new bartender. So I'll go in, undercover, and control the situation by introducing the patrons to my special home-brewed sarsaparilla.
Your mustache looks bigger. What have you been feeding it?
Pay attention, Sly. You'll need to enter through that window and make your way to the ventilation system. Meanwhile, I'll have the goons inside so sugared up, they'll be seeing double until they crash hard. Once you launch the RC car in the vents, I'll take control and guide it to Toothpick's office.
You're not gonna start wearing that mustache all the time, are you?
Jealousy is such an ugly emotion, Sly.
Watch your back, pal. This place looks pretty rough.
Will do. See you inside.
Establishment is in dire need of an expert tap jockey. I've got sarsaparilla? Well, these guys look thirsty. Let's see, I can move left and right simply by using the left stick. When a patron steps up to the bar, I can slide him a drink by pressing the X button. These guys don't look like patient types, so I'd better make it fast. I'd better keep an eye on the sarsaparilla gauge. It's going to take my whole supply to quiet this bunch. The meter should indicate how much sarsaparilla I have left. Something tells me it's going to take every drop.
Are still awake. I need to be careful. I just need to stay off the floor.
Looking good, Sly.
Thank you.
just need to reach the ventilation duct.
Just a little further to that vent.
All right, Fly, plug that little beauty. All right, baby, let's see what you can do for Medley. Stay away from my car, you eight-legged bully! I can't let those spiders put a bite on the RC car! My car, you eight-legged bully!
My partner's got an ace up his sleeve, and we're about to go all in. This trump card's going to crush Cooper and the rest of his clean jumping gang. We's going to learn a mew don't yank a rattlesnake's tail, lest you're looking to get bit. Then, we are going to finish loading up the train and haul our sweet little kisters out of this one-horse town. Once we get that loot back into present day, I, Toothpick, going to be worth millions! Oopsie.
Dang it, boss! Would you watch where you're pointing that thing?
Are you talking to me?
Whoa, boss, whoa! I'm sorry, I didn't mean nothing!
Hurt one of you to break out the dust clock once in a while, huh? Take a gander at this office. It's disgrace. It's so dusty, I can barely stand it. What do you take me for, huh? A chinchilla? Do I have to do everything around here, huh? I make the plans. I steal the gold.
That's not good. Looks like Toothpick rustled himself a pretty lady.
Sweet, jumping jackrabbit! That's no lady, that's Carmelita! What is she doing here?
You know her?
I'm afraid so. Something is very wrong here, Tennessee. But all quantum physics aside, we have to rescue her. Nobody can get there faster than you. I'll grab Sly and Murray, and we'll meet you in the van. Just get going!
Huh. I wonder who Bentley's lady friend is. Kidnapping? That Toothpick's lower than a snake in a ditch! Rescuing pretty ladies is a hobby of mine, anyway.
Too happy to get rid of this one. Her tongue sharp enough to cut leather.
Stinking cowards! Afraid to untie me and bite like men? I swear, when I get out of this...
No sense fretting about that, little lady. Cry, cry, little dear, yes. Just enjoy the ride!
I'm coming, Miss Carmelita! I need to blow that barrier away!
Okay! You can stop anytime!
I gotta keep the road clear of obstacles! Some legs. This is getting a lot hairy. Some fool just turned up the heat.
You enjoying this?
You, ma'am. Why, I'm Tennessee Kid.
Don't tell me. You're a Cooper, right? I knew it.
Yes, ma'am. Bentley told me you...
Stop calling me ma'am. The name's Inspector Fox. Wait, Bentley's here?
Well, looks like they're right behind us.
Carmelita, I'm glad you're okay.
Why, that conniving little...
Much obliged for a helping hand, Inspector Fox. Let me run these banditos over to prison, and I'll be back for you, all in lickety-split. Of course, you feeling neighborly? You could just turn yourselves in.
As much as I like the idea of Sly in a cell, nobody kidnaps Inspector Carmelita Fox and gets away with it.
I reckon that also includes tying her to a runaway stage?
Watch it. I'm in no mood for smart remarks. Now, are you ready for another mission, Tennessee?
Yes, ma'am. Oh, I mean, I surely am, Inspector Fox.
This river is dangerous, but it leads back to the prison. Way I figure it, they won't be expecting us to come this way. You sure you're up to this, Miss Fox?
That's Inspector Fox? But just call me Carmelita. Thanks for the rescue, by the way.
My pleasure. Inspector? You some kind of sheriff? How'd you get mixed up with Sly?
It's a long, complicated story. Right now, I need to rescue that ringtail, so I can wring his neck.
Ooh-wee, you are feisty. You remind me of this one little gal who...
So, what's this prison like, anyway?
Well, plenty of fire, for starters.
Terrific. Let's get going.
Miss Carmelita, you didn't forget how to use that pistol, did you?
Not a chance. I just press the R1 button to pull the trigger. And I can press and hold the L1 button to focus my aim. Wait to give that ringtail a piece of my mind.
Thank you.
Into this mess.
Nice shooting, Carmelita.
How about less sweet talk and more action? Tennessee, it looks like you'll have to go on ahead. I'll find another way there.
Do get a mite irritating. You can't beat the Tennessee King!
Tennessee! This way!
Missy, you're a real catch! You can't mess with it. Looks like we got company, Miss Carmelita, and not the friendly kind. I'll keep the raft still, and you blast those damn jackalopes!
Why don't you guys just get out of my way?
We got attackers to the left!
Maybe we should focus on the mission, Tennessee. Steady, Tennessee!
Bingo! Now that's what I call straight shooting! Those steers up there mean business!
Huh, that switch looks kinda important.
A sack of gold nuggets. Shucks, these galoots are not smart. You fellas are messing with the wrong outlaw. Get your boots on, gang! Tennessee's all the way!
Tennessee, this way! Go on. I'll stay here and cover you.
All right! Who wants to Well, bring it on then, boys! Shoot! Time's a-wasting! Pick it up, Tennessee!
You idiots! Better start shooting straight! If those prisoners escape, you're taking their legs!
All right! Who wants to eat some lead? Carmelita, are you all right?
I am. No thanks to you. I should leave you in that cage after what you pulled, Sly Cooper.
I know. Look, I can explain everything.
Why, if it wasn't for this handsome and charming gentleman, I wouldn't even be here.
Aw, shucks.
Handsome and charming? Really? Look, Carmelita, I know...
Save it, Sly. All I want to know right now is how I get back to Paris.
Actually, Carmelita, I was more curious how you got here in the first place.
But guys, where's the van?
We'll have to track it down later, Murray. Now, what were you saying, Carmelita?
It's a long story, Bentley. Let's get moving and I'll tell you. When I saw that arrogant little, that no-good lying, I should have tied his mangy tail around his neck. I should have blasted that smug look right off his face. I should probably just finish my story. After the Cooper gang escaped at the museum, I decided to follow my nose and take a look around. I'd been investigating the trading of stolen antiquities on the black market, but I'd never guessed that two-faced ringtail was involved. Then as I turned a corner, I was stunned to see a huge stash of stolen treasure right there in the museum. And even more shocking, Cyril Le Paradox himself unloading them. I couldn't believe it. The billionaire art collector and museum patron was behind this? I was so surprised that by the time I reacted, his goons already had me covered. Then that slimy sawed-off runt had me thrown into some vile machine. And the next thing I knew, I was playing cowboys and criminals. The Old West? Time travel? It was completely loco. Sure, Le Paradox had done some time in his youth, but he'd been squeaky clean ever since. And Interpol had never considered him a suspect. There were rumors about the source of his wealth, but nothing had ever been proven. Now I knew I'd solved that mystery. And of course, Cooper and his little friends were involved somehow. Why was I not surprised? The Fleabag tried to feed me some story about having to rob the museum to save the future. But I was done listening to that liar. I needed to get back to Paris. But that toad toothpick had stolen Murray's van, and Bentley's time machine along with it. I finally cracked the case, and now I was stuck in this lousy dust bowl with the Cooper gang. I don't know what made me angrier. Not being able to bust the lowlife skunk, or being trapped here with that lying ringtail. Ooh! The only bearable thing about this whole mess was that at least Cooper's ancestor was a gentleman.